Nope, doesn't happen. Protecting your pet against external parasites is, like it or not, on you. Me. And why should you do it? Not simply because fleas, ticks, mosquitoes and their friends are a nuisance, but because they can carry pathogens of dangerous diseases such as heartworms, Lyme disease, leishmaniosis, ehrlichiosis, babesiosis, tapeworms and morning zombie breath syndrome. One of these I just made up. There's a variety of alternatives to achieve protection, and pharmaceutical companies are in constant noble competition for the privilege of selling you their products. To save you from drowning in a sea of choices, here is a helpful guide to the kinds of preparations available for your pet against external parasites. First things first, what parasites exactly should you be concerned about? That depends on your pet's habitat and lifestyle, but generally speaking, fleas, ticks and flying bloodsuckers such as mosquitoes and sandflies pose the most common threat. Ear mites are very often found in outdoor cats. Other external parasites infest pets less frequently. When fighting these pests, there are three main strategies to follow, which are to repel them, to kill them, or to cunningly destroy their future, using what are called insect growth regulators. When talking about repellency, many people think of a force field surrounding the animal, which deflects incoming ticks, fleas, mosquitoes, and the neighbor's annoying children. Some insect repellents do contain volatile compounds, which from the parasite's point of view smell like a mall Santa at the end of the day, and as such can work from small distances, but their effect relies on their evaporation, making them only last a few hours. Most products work differently. Repellency is achieved by what is called the hot foot effect. The chemicals in question do not evaporate, but attach to the body surface, and work their magic only when the unsuspecting parasite comes in contact with them. It's like hugging your spouse, when in fact it is a bear. The killing effect doesn't require much explanation. It turns a hostile parasite into a friendly one. Depending on the active ingredient, this could happen purely by contact, or through the first sip of medicated blood. Insect growth regulators, or IGRs, are substances that don't harm parasites directly, but prevent their development. They are like a family planning program for parasites, authored by Henry VIII. Eggs laid by IGR-affected arthropods have the sole function of looking pretty in the sunset. They cannot hatch, thus becoming the unfruitful end of a generation. Larvae affected by IGRs are unable to turn into adults. After flunking all their exams in high school, they write blogs about how life sucks and eventually die of an overdose of self-pity. When it comes to products, there are two large categories of formulations. Topicals, such as spot-ons, collars, shampoos, powders and sprays, are applied on your pet, as opposed to systemics, tablets and injectables, which are to be put inside. In general, topicals stay on the surface and don't affect the body, while systemics do the exact opposite. However, some topical preparations get absorbed through the skin and produce a systemic effect. But what can you as a pet owner make of all this? I'll ask my lawyer. We'll talk about it in the next part of the video. Health. It makes you live longer. The technical information in this video was fact-checked by Dr. Ákos Jerzsele, PhD, veterinarian, pharmacologist, Uber warlock. I thank him very much. As much as I thank Siva for its support.